You've probably noticed this strip on the back of our shingles. Now, a lot of people incorrectly refer to it as an adhesive strip. We at ICO call it release tape, and although you might not know it now, there's a very good reason why it's there. In this video, we'll explain what it's for, why it's on the back of our shingles, and hopefully answer your questions about removing it. The simple answer to all of your questions is that it truly has no function in application. During the bundle stacking process, we alternate the shingles so that the sealant buttons of the shingle below align with the release tape on the back of the shingle above. Its purpose is twofold: to prevent shingles from sticking together and to keep the sealant buttons free of dust and debris prior to installation when they are being shipped for delivery. Since the release tape is located on the back of each shingle, it's not visible once it's been installed and therefore not necessary to remove. There's even been a widespread myth that started about having to remove these strips, but that's simply not the case. It should be left as is, intact on the back of each shingle as they are nailed down. The most we can gather about this rumor was that it probably began way, way back in the 1950s. To explain, let's take a trip down memory lane. Back then, self-sealing shingles were all the rage, and quickly becoming the norm among roofers everywhere. They all featured a strip of tape on the back that had to be removed before installation. Otherwise, the self-sealing would be more or less a non-sealing. Thankfully, we've come a long way since those days. We hope this video has been helpful to you. If you're looking to learn more from the experts at ICO, please subscribe.